Good. All right. So, who here, just by a show of hands, every once in a while feels a lack of motivation or feels lazy sometimes? You just don't want to do anything. We all do, right? In high school, I kind of had that problem. I was in so many things in school. I was in football, honors courses, student government. I had special courses that I took on the side, like college prep courses, and I was in theater. And so when I got home, I often felt a lack of motivation. I felt tired and I felt lazy. And as cited in Robertson's 1996 Wordsworth Dictionary of Quotations, French philosopher Jules Renard once said, "Failure is not our only punishment for laziness. There's also the success of others." And so what this quote means is that not only when you have a lack of motivation or you feel lazy, the only problem is not that you fail, is that you see others be more successful than yourself. And by show of hands, we all want to be successful, yes? Is that, yes? Okay. Good. So the thing is, if we all want to be successful, we all need this lack of, or we all need motivation. We can't have this lack of motivation or this laziness holding us back. So today, I'm going to show you how to become self-motivated. First, we're going to define what motivation is. Then we're going to look at people who are successful, as well as the average employee, and decide and discuss what motivates them. And third, we're going to find out how to apply these ideas to our own personal lives to become motivated. So our first question is, what is motivation? In the April 1984 volume of Psychological Review, Humphreys and Revell define motivation as the hypothetical construct that has traditionally been used to describe and explain differences in intensity and direction of behavior. So, in this quote, they have broken down motivation into two parts, intensity and direction. And a simple way to think of this is, intensity is how bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? How hard are you going to push for what you want? Direction is, how are you going to get what you want? And so, by this train of thought, we can break down intensity into effort, which is the ability consciously given by your mind and by your body towards a given task, and vigor, which is the strength or the force of that action that you have given. And direction. Direction is defined by, or is split into approach and on-task effort. An approach is your strategy and your execution. It is the basic, how are you going to go about getting what you want? On-task effort is not being distracted, staying on task, using your effort from the intensity side to stay on task in your approach from the direction side. Now, in order to further understand how this applies in the world and to further understand motivation, let's look at what motivates people. So in a May 2011 article on Examiner.com, Sir Richard Branson, who you guys might know, owns Virgin Mobile, Virgin Airlines, that entire Virgin company, Sir Richard Branson gives an answer on what motivates people. Curiosity and inquisition at a younger age. As they grow older, people develop a desire to prove themselves. And once they reach an even older age, they follow their personal interests and passions. So they're simply motivated at a young age by curiosity. They want to know if they can do things. They want to know how far can they go. Once they reach an older age, they want to prove that they can. They know they can do things. They know they can be successful, and they want to show everybody else. And then at that final stage, they follow these personal interests and passions. There's a lack of care as to what others think, and they follow they're motivated by what they personally want. And aside in an April 2013 TED article by Jessica Gross, multiple studies have shown other outside factors of motivation, such as a study done by Harvard, which this is more of a study on employees, on your average employee, not as much as Sir Richard Branson, these wildly successful entrepreneurs. And the study was done with bionicle figures. If some of you guys know, it's these small Lego figurines. And what they did is they had two different groups. They had a control group and they had a separate test group. And for each bionicle that the worker constructed, they would give them $1. And this the study was to find out how long they were motivated to push on to keep creating these bionicles. One of the groups, however, they Yeah, they took these binoculars that they made and they stacked them along the front of the table so they could see how far along they were. The other group, binoculars were taken off the table, immediately deconstructed. The group that could see their work, that could appreciate their work, that was motivated by their progress they had made, made 11 binoculars as opposed to, on average, they made the 11 binoculars as opposed to the 7 made by the group who did not appreciate and see their work. As well, there's a New York Times study done in a hospital that there were two groups of doctors, and they placed a sign above the sink saying, on one group saying that if you wash your hands, you are less likely to catch a disease. Above the other sink, they placed a sign saying, if you wash your hands, patients are less likely to catch disease. Now, the doctors who washed their hands at the sink that said patients are less likely to catch a disease washed their hands 3 times as long, used 3 times as much soap, and washed their hands 3 times, on the average of 3 times more throughout the day. So we can derive from this that two main points of motivation are appreciation of your work and helping of others. How does this apply to us, though? How can we use this to motivate ourselves and to take this direction? In becoming self-motivated, in an article in December 2012 on Forbes.com, Paul Brown gives 4 reasons why people may not be getting what they want. And they all have to do with the direction of motivation. Habits, lack of means, perceived costs are too high, or they're lying to themselves. He right away describes the fourth, lying to yourself, tends to not be a huge issue. So we're gonna focus on the other three. The way that you can become a self-motivated person is by taking Sir Richard Branson and Paul Brown and these New York Times studies, and take these three sources of motivation and apply them together. So you can use Sir Richard Branson's personal interests and passions to understand what we want, so we're not lying to ourselves. We can use curiosity and inquisition to conquer obstacles such as lack of means and high perceived costs. A desire to prove oneself helps us form successful habits. And to look back and appreciate your work and do something that benefits others greatly has statistically shown that increases your motivation. In summation, we've learned what motivation is, what motivates successful people, and how to apply it to ourselves. Now that you guys know how to become motivated, I encourage you to apply the intensity side of motivation to yourselves now that you have the direction to go out and be successful.